हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वन क्लिक एग्री यूट्यूब चैनल। प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू अवर चैनल एंड हिट द बेल आइकॉन टू गेट लेटेस्ट वीडियो नोटिफिकेशन। हेल्थ एडवाइजरी: स्मोकिंग टोबैको किल्स। प्लीज रीड द डिस्क्लेमर ऑफ वन क्लिक एग्री यूट्यूब चैनल। Now again short briefing of our One Click Agri YouTube channel. We will be providing videos with notes and study material for all agricultural competitive exams. So the outline of our lecture series will be bifurcated into two broad categories, that is 1 lakh agriculture objectives and theory of all agricultural subjects. So here you will get subject wise objective along with notes. And we have selected topic agronomy, and we will be continue it from question number 61 to 75. Let's see the question number 61. How many seeds are needed for planting 1 hectare of sugarcane? The right answer for this question: 35,000 to 40,000. Here is a chart in that the three birded seeds required 35,000 to 40,000 per hectare. Then two budded 80,000 seeds per hectare, and one budded or single budded 1,20,000 seeds per hectare. Sometimes you will find 1,25,000 seeds per hectare. Please be remember these two values. Then here a chart in that planting material, it should have 1/3 to 1/2 of the cane, and it contains nitrogen and glucose, and nitrogen and glucose helps for better germination. Then planted seeds, it should have 3 buds, and the age of the planted seeds 10 to 12 months. Then planting space in North India 60 to 90 centimeter, and in South India and specifically for Arsali sugarcane 90 to 120 centimeter. Next question: trench method of sugarcane planting is used in. The right answer for this question: coastal area. We have chart here in that given the different sugarcane planting methods. First is a flatbed method, and used this method is used in North India. Second is the ridge and furrow method. This is used in South India. Trench method used in coastal area. And distant planting method. This is the first grow in the nursery, and after 45 to 60 days transplant to the main field. This is the distant planting method of sugarcane. Ryan's planting method of sugarcane, in that this method is not adopted in India, please be remember, and used for the gap filling. Then mechanical planting, this is a cheap planting method. Then skip furrow, this combined flatbed plus trench, and the gap of the 90 centimeter left after each 2 rows, this is known as a skip furrow. And pit planting method, this practiced in the slopy land and cane planted in the pit in a triangle manner, and also known as the contour planting. Please be remember these words, very, very important. Contour planting is related to the sugarcane also, and the related to the pit planting method of sugarcane. Next question: with a too much increase in nitrogen application, sugar contained in juice. The right answer for this question: decreases. The we have research paper in that they were given nitrogen doses higher than 150 kg per hectare is absorbed greater than those required by the crop, thus characterizing luxury consumption. This given by Muncho et al. In 1996, and other studies have also pointed out reduction in sugarcane bricks as well as pole, it means the sugar content in the juice percentage, due to effect of nitrogen doses higher than 120 kg per hectare, and these were given by Franco et al. In 2008 as well as Megda et al. In 2012. Next question. Ipirikena melanoleuca is a parasitoid effective against. The right answer for this question, sugarcane pyrrhela. And we have a little bit more information over here about the terminology parasitoid and parasites. And the, what is meant by the parasitoid? Parasitoid, when an insect itself a parasite, then it is called as a parasitoid. For example, egg parasitoid of Trichogramma chelonis and Trichogramma japonicum are used to control the tissue borer of sugarcane and rice. The second term is a parasite. So what is meant by parasite? It is attack on the phytophagous insects. What is meant by the phytophagus? The especially of an insects or other invertebrates feeding on the plant, that is a phytophagus. With respect of the rice millibug, Leptomastix dictylopi controlled common millibugs, that means Phalaenococcus citri or Planococcus citri. The rice leafhopper to control is used thymate at the rate 1.3% per 100 gram of seeds, and another one, 1 liter of chloropyrifos 20 EC in 250 liter of water per hectare. And sugarcane pyrrhela also controlled by fungus, that is a Metarhizium anisopyli. And sugarcane pyrrhela also known as a leafhopper, that is a Pyrrhela purpurcella. Please be remember this. And Ipirikena melanoleuca, the parasitoid is released periodically, and the number is 4000 to 5000 cocoons or 4 lakh to 5 lakh eggs per hectare. Please be remember this. Next question. Which one of the following type of resistance is present in a crop variety showing high degree of resistance to a pathogen but becoming susceptible it after large scale cultivation for 4 to 5 years and so on? The right answer for this question, vertical resistance. And the definition over here is that kind of resistance in plant variety that effective against some races of pathogen only and not against others, and it is called as vertical resistance. And it is also known as race specific resistance, major gene resistance, strong resistance, qualitative resistance, monogenic resistance, oligogenic resistance, hypersensitive resistance, arginine resistance, racial resistance, unstable resistance, and differential resistance. Please be remember these other names of the vertical resistance. Let's see the little bit more information about the horizontal resistance. The definition of the horizontal resistance is when the resistance is evenly spread against the all races of the pathogen. Please remember, this is the all races of pathogen, and vertical resistance is some races of pathogen, and it is known as or called as a horizontal resistance. Sometimes it is known as or called as a lateral resistance. And the another name of the horizontal resistance are partial resistance, race non-specific resistance, general resistance, quantitative resistance, polygenic resistance, adult plant field additive, durable, stable, non-differential, rate reducing, minor gene, and incomplete or multi-gene resistance. Here is the, in this chart, the horizontal resistance and vertical resistance comparison given in a short. The horizontal resistance is multi-gene, vertical is oligogene, are monogenic. Then horizontal resistance, race non-specific, vertical race specific, horizontal durable, vertical less durable, horizontal quantitative resistance, vertical qualitative resistance, horizontal environmentally influenced or vertical environmentally non-influenced. Horizontal resistance often effective against necrotroph, and vertical resistance often effective against biotroph. And the horizontal resistance is a partial, it means R is equal to greater than 0 to less than 1. It means R is equal to resistance against pathogen. And the vertical resistance is a complete, that is R is equal to 0 or 1. Let's see the what is meant by the necrotroph and biotroph. The necrotroph, it means a parasite organism that kills the living cells of the host and then feeds on the dead matter. And biotrophs, a plant pathogenic fungi which establish a long-term feeding relationship with the living cell of a host without killing it as a part of the infection process. The only difference between the necrotrophs and biotrophs is necrotrophs kills living cells and feeds on dead matter, and biotrophs, this is the pathogenic fungi and feeding relationship with the living cells without killing them. This is the difference between the necrotroph and biotroph. The examples of the stable protection and example of unstable protection. The stable protection is related to the horizontal resistance, and unstable protection is related to the vertical resistance. In a stable protection, insecticides, that is a natural pyrethrins, and fungicide, that is a Bordeaux mixture, we are using this against the many pathogens. And in unstable protection, insecticide, that is DDT, resistance to house flies, and fungicide, that is metalaxyl, resistant to the blight of potato, that is a race specific, and that is the vertical resistance. Next question. Which of the following food grain are most coarse? The right answer for this question, Paspalum scorbiculatum, and it is also known as kodo millet. The we have rest of the three options over here. In that, first is a Panicum miliaceum, is known as a China or proso millet, please be remember. Then Ichinicola frumentans, it's also known as a savan or barnyard millet, please be remember this. And then Setaria italica is also known as a foxtail millet, Italian millet, German millet, or Kakun millet. Please be remember, this is new name, the Kakun millet. And the highlighted is the important one. Next question. Which of the following pairs of crops and critical stage of irrigation is not correctly matched? Bajra arid, correctly matched. Cotton pre-flowering, correctly matched. Wheat crown root initiation, correctly matched. Groundnut pod development is the incorrect one. And peg formation is the critical stage of irrigation in groundnut. Please be remember this. Already we have discussed about the peg formation in a previous lecture. So that go back and please watch our previous lectures, as well as the 20 videos on horticulture. That is very, very important. You go back and watch it. Next question. contribution of flag leaf in photosynthesis is about? The right answer for this question, 52%. And we have a recent paper in that the flag leaf contribution was given 45 to 58% of photosynthetic performance. If they are asking about the grain yield, that is 41 to 55% contribution of flag leaf in grain yield. Next question. Which one of the following crop is most sensitive to both excess moisture and drought? The right answer for this question, maize. And with respect of sorghum, sorghum is known as camel crop because it has the capacity to withstand against drought. And one note here, pearl millet is the most drought tolerant crop among cereals and millets. Please be remember this. This is very, very important. Next question. Atrazine used as an antitranspirant. The right answer for this question affect the closure and opening of the stomata. It means affect the closing and opening of the stomata. In that, the another examples are TMA, then CO2, 2,4-D, phosphon-D, potassium metabisulfide. The rest of the option here, but before we are going to this information, let's see the what is mean by the antitranspirants. The definition of antitranspirants, it means the material are applied to plant surface to reduce transpiration from plant is known as antitranspirants. Then reduce the growth of the crop. In that, these chemicals reduce the shoot growth and increases root growth and thus enable the plant to resistant drought. And this is the one of the character of the drought resistance plants. Please be remember, this reduces the shoot growth and increases the root growth. And they are also includes stomata closing in that cycocel, that is CCC. It's also known as clomequot and phosphor. Please be remember these examples. And in the form of thin layer on the surface, leaf surface. In that the two categories is there. First is the thin, in that hexadecanol and cetyl alcohol and paclobutrazole. In a thick, mobile leaf, silicone, oils, waxes. It means oils, waxes, waxols, S800, HICO 110R and Folicot. Please be remember this Folicot, mobile leaf, silicon, and in thin, hexadecanol and cetyl alcohol. And in a reflective type of antitranspirants, examples are kaolin, that is 5%. Then China clay, calcium bicarbonate and lime water. Please be remember this. Next question. Which one of the following pair of weeds and crops is not correctly matched? The right answer for this question, typha sugarcane. In that, the khandkudi is associated with sugarcane, please remember, and typha is a aquatic weed. We have a chart here, in that given parasitic nature, it means the semi-root, semi-stem, total root, total stem, and the weeds and host crop or plants. First is a semi-root in that weed Striga, and the host plant of Striga weed are sorghum and sugarcane. Then same stem weed Loranthus species, host crop mango, and sometimes you will find on silver oak. Please be remember this also. Then total root Orobanchi species, or some calls that Orobanchi species, observed on tobacco. And total stem, that is Cuscuta, it is also known as Amarbel, observed on lucerne. How do you remember this? First is the semi and second is total. You make the short form of this ST and RSRS. RSRS, it means root, stem, root, stem. STRSRS. Then how do you remember the weeds? One trick here, LOC. We know the line of control, LOC. That means SLOC. STRSRS, SLOC. And already you know the host plant or crops. It's very simple to remember this chart. Next question. Atrazine effectively control grasses in maize field without causing harm to the crop plant, as a degradation of the chemical in maize plant occurs due to the presence of. The right answer for this question, GSH enzyme. It means glycoside hydrolase. If you will find this type of question in the examination, it's better to left this question. If you know the right answer, then you attempt this type of questions. Next question. Which one of the following is mycoherbicide? That means bioherbicide. The right answer for this question, Colego. And the rest of the three herbicides over here, in that first, that is a dicot. And dicot is synthetic, non-persistent and contact herbicide. Then C option, in that metsulfuron-methyl. This is the organic compound content herbicide and it is classified as sulfonyl urea herbicide. And the trade name of metsulfuron-methyl is Met-5 and it kills broadleaf weeds. Option number D, Bromacil. It is an organic compound content herbicide. But one note is here, very very important. Bromacil was a first registered as a pesticide in US in 1961. Please be remember, first registered as a pesticide and now used as a herbicide, that is a Bromacil, and used for control brush control and non-cropland area weeds. See the chart here, in that given commercialized bioherbicides or mycoherbicides. There is a important already we have highlighted here. First is a Divine, in that Phytophthora palmivora content is there and it controls the weed strangle vine. Then product Bipolaris content Bipolaris sorghicola and it controls Johnson grass. Then Colego, it contains Colitotrichum glycosporoides and it controls Saccharum spontaneum. Then you can read the rest of the products of bioherbicides. Please pause the video here and read it. In that the important is Velgo, then Lubo2, then Dr. Biosage. is very very important. Please read all of them. Next question. Which one of the crop rotation is the best for maintaining soil fertility? The right answer for this question: soybean, wheat, green gram. Next question. Productivity of an intercrop per unit area of ground compared with that expected from sole crop sown in the same proportion is known as. The right answer for this question: land equivalent ratio. See the definition over here, in that the ratio of the area under sole cropping to the area under intercropping needed to give equal amounts of yield at the same management level. That is the land equivalent ratio. And the first options over here in that competitive ratio. And the competitive ratio was given by Ville and Rao in 1980. And this used as an indicator to evaluate the competitive ability of a different species in intercropping. This is the competitive ability. It shows in the competitive ratio. And the crop performance ratio, this means the productivity of an intercrop per unit area of ground compared with that expected from sole crop sown in the same proportion. This means the crop performance ratio. Let's see the formula of land equivalent ratio, that is LER. It means the relative land area occupied by a sole crop that is required to produce yield achieved in intercropping. Formula is here, LER is equal to yield of intercrop. It means A plus B. A means sole crop, B means intercrop, divided by yield of sole crop, that is A. When LER is greater than 1, then intercropping is beneficial. Please be remember this. And LER 1.10, it means mixture gives 10% more yield. Example is here, sole crop or sole yields, this is the intercropped yield. The sole yield is grain 5 tons per hectare. See here the grains and here the fruits. Fruits 15 ton per hectare. This is given on the basis of hectare. We required land or taken land 0.8 hectare here for the grains and 0.6 hectare for the fruit crops. Let's calculate the actual yield of sole crops, that is 5 ton per hectare into 0.8 hectare. It means it gives the 4 ton per hectare. And fruits 15 ton per hectare in 0.6 hectare area, it gives 9 ton per hectare in particular area. It means it's required total area 0.8 hectare plus 0.6 hectare. It means 1.4 hectare area to get this particular 4 and 9 ton yield. When we intercrop this fruit crop and grains, then we get 4 ton per hectare grains and fruit 9 ton per hectare in 1 hectare area. It means LER gives 1.4 answer over here in the ratio format. And the conclusion of this whole example, that means 1.4 hectare of sole cropping area would be required to produce the same yield as 1 hectare of the intercropped area. So the intercropping is beneficial as compared to the sole cropping. And another words, the 40% of yield is increased in intercropping as compared to the sole cropping. Please be remember this. Please watch lecture number 6. And now it's time to subscribe, like and share our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get latest video notification. Thank you for being with us. See you soon in next lecture. Bye bye.